Mihara, this is May and welcome back to May channel. In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to add effects in your 3D file in Unity. Now, I'll be using the Unity version 2018 since I am having problems with the latest Unity and I don't like its errors. Like, I have been facing many errors in the latest one, so yes. Now, I'm just going to say that no, you can't create this on your phones. You'll need a computer or a laptop. Now, I am also filming this live, so I'm very sorry for my grammatical errors and my stutters, okay? So, let's start meow meow! I have here my Unity, of course. This is the old version, Unity 2018.4.22F1. Now, I really recommend this to beginners in Unity since the new Unity have lots of problems. I mean, for me, okay? For me. Okay, wait. I just loved how my hair swayed. Okay. Let's go back to the tutorial, okay? So, I have here lots of 3D files and I already have a ring tutorial. I mean, on how to create a ring. So, let's use the FBX file of the ring for this effect tutorial. Now, the first thing you'll do is, of course, add materials on your FBX files if you have FBX file. But if you have the prefab file, well, you can skip this step. Now, to make this a prefab file, let me just delete this first. To make a prefab file, you just need to click your FBX file, right-click, and then Zepeto Studio, and then convert to Zepeto Style. This will make the FBX file convert into prefab file. Now, after this one, you just have to click the prefab file and then click Open Prefab. After clicking that, you'll be redirected to this empty space. Now, as you can see, there is a ring sample here. Ring sample is the name of my file. So, you just need to right-click on this one, and then Effects, and then Particle System. Now, you'll be able to create the most basic particle system. Now, let's say you want to create something that is falling. We'll need to rotate this like that. Well, I like rotating it manually, but you can also type in here 90 degrees. Wait. Okay. And as you can see, it's already falling down. Now, we'll need to move this upward. Okay. Where is our ring? I can't see our ring. Wait. Okay. I lost the ring. Wait. Where is the ring? Oh, there it is. It's very small. Okay, it's very small. But it's just that our particle system is too large. We'll need to resize it. Now, to resize it, you just have to change this start size into 0.5, I guess. Is that good enough? No, it's still too large. Okay, let's change it into 0.3. This is good enough. This is a good enough particle. Okay, now if you would want to change its color, you can just edit this one. See? And then what do I teach? The shape. You can change the shape, like how it would go down or how it would move. You can change this one into smaller. Look at the behavior of the effect. Now you can also make it spread like that. But usually zippeters, I mean item creators, do this and then resize it up a bit. It's good. They usually do this to make their particles. And so the next thing is maybe color over lifetime. You can make it a gradient. Wait, let me move this to the frame. Okay. The top part is for transparency. The bottom part is for the colors. For example, I would want a gradient from blue to red to blue. See that? Okay. Now, if you change the upper part, this one, to like this, you can see that it is faded, right? That is what the first, that is how the upper part affects the whole. Now, we can just maximize it again. It will be visible. And this is just how you create particles, effects in Unity. Now there are lots, wait, my nose is itchy. Okay, now there are lots of settings you can experiment on this one. It's up to you, really. You can just experiment and experiment and you'll be able to get your very own settings. Now, we can also do the size over lifetime. You can change the graph, of course, bigger, smaller to bigger, or bigger to smaller. It's really up to you. See that? That's just it. Now, I actually have this. Should I teach this? Okay, I'll teach you this. The renderer setting. You can change this into mesh and then add a material here. I actually have pre-made materials. Where is it? What is it, this one? Particles. Okay, here. Now let's just say flower. Wait. I'm sorry. Okay. Flower, where is the flower? This one. You can't see it because it's too small. You have to change the start size. Okay, 5. No. 25. 40. Okay. It's a little bit weird, right? It's like bickering. Is that the right term? In that way, I usually do rotation over lifetime, so it would rotate. Mm-hmm. And of course, you'll have to add a material on that so that you can see the mesh. But I don't have a pre-made material right now, so I can't really show you. Let's try this one. You see that? That's just it. And that is how you create effects in Unity. Now I was the one who did the mesh by myself, so you can also create it if you are using 3D softwares like Maya and Blender. But yes. So I guess that's it for this video. As always, thank you so much for watching and bye bye!